Simple discount notes. In this first part of section 9.3, we'll take a look at the basic terms used with simple discount notes. A simple interest note works like this. Someone borrows $2,000. They're charged an interest of $125, and at the maturity date, they will have paid back the principal or the face value of the loan plus the interest. This is known as or referred to as the maturity value. A simple discount note for the same amount of money as the last one has a face value of $2,000, and initially when the loan starts, the borrower receives $1,875. This is referred to as the proceeds. The interest on this loan is $125, just like in the last one. This amount is called the discount, and at the time of the due date, the borrower pays back $2,000. This is known as the maturity value. So let's define what exactly a bank discount is. This is a bank fee or interest charged on a note. It's subtracted from the face value to find the proceeds of the loan. This is just a different type of loan arrangement. Proceeds then, and it is symbolized with the letter P, not to be confused with the P that we use for principal when we were calculating simple interest, but nonetheless, the proceeds are found by taking the face value minus the bank discount. And here we have an abbreviation for this formula. And in other words, proceeds are the loan amount. It's found by taking the repayment amount or the maturity value minus the interest. So you can think of bank discount as interest. And here we have a listing of the terms that are specific to a discount note. The face value is the maturity value. The bank discount we will represent with the letter B is the interest. The discount rate is the percentage represented with a D, and time is in years, just like when we're calculating simple interest. And one last term to take a look at is proceeds. Proceeds are the loan amount. So let's take a look at using the terminology. We have a simple discount note of $4,300. This is the amount that they're borrowing. The interest charged for this loan is $285. And they're asking us several questions here. So to fill these in, since this is a simple discount note, and that's essential that you recognize the difference between a simple interest and a simple discount note, the face value is, as I mentioned, the amount that's being borrowed. The proceeds are the difference between the face value and the bank discount or the interest being charged. So we will subtract the two values that were given. So during the term of the loan, this is the amount of money that the individual would have the use of. They went in for $4,300, but they proceeded out the door with the difference between the face value and the interest being charged. The discount is the specific term to describe the interest, the amount charged for the use of this money. The maturity value of a discount note is the face value, the amount that was asked for initially. Here we have another one, similar to the last one, where they're going to ask us for a series of values. Key note here is that this is a simple discount versus a simple interest note. That means the face value is the amount asked for this loan. The proceeds, the amount that the individual uses during the term of the loan, is the difference between the face value and the interest charged, which is the $11,750. The discount amount is the specific term in a simple discount note to represent the interest charge, $750, and the maturity value is the amount the individual pays at the end of the term, which is the same as the face value. So it's the proceeds plus the discount, or simply just the face value. To calculate the bank discount, remember this is interest, we take the face value times the discount rate times the time. This has very similar feel, hopefully, to you for calculating the simple interest where we take principal times rate times time. Here we have an abbreviation, the variables representing these values, and a note here telling us that the face value is the maturity value. Why the M there for face value? And we can use this circle formula to help us with various arrangements for calculating bank discount given three of the four variables. So let's do some calculations determining bank discount. Here we have a complete example. We have a face value or maturity value of $2,000. The bank discount rate is 6%. The length or the time is 90 days, the term for this. The discount, which is the bank discount, is $30, which is our interest. And the proceeds of this discounted note are $1,970. So where did those values come from? Let's verify that bank discount amount. So to calculate the bank discount, we take the maturity value, which is the $2,000, times it by the discount rate, which is 6%, and times it by the time in years. Time needs some special handling because the term is in days. We need to express this in terms of years, and so you can see that we're putting 90 over 360. So we have the maturity value, or the face value, times the discount rate as a percent, times the time in terms of years, resulting in the bank discount amount of $30. And I should mention, oftentimes when we become familiar with a certain procedure or formula, we shorten it up, and oftentimes you will see discount short for bank discount. So that's where the B is coming from. Even though we're showing discount, it can cause some confusion. So discount alone is just short for bank discount, and we're letting that stand for B. This next one is asking us to calculate the discount. We're given a maturity value of $800 with a discount rate of 4.5% and a term of 120 days. To find the bank discount B, we will take the maturity value $800, we will times it by the rate expressed as a decimal, times it by the time in terms of years. Because it's days, we need to divide by 360. That result ends up in a $12 interest charge, which we refer to as a bank discount or casually as a discount. Let's calculate proceeds then. And here's a complete example. We're back to the one we had just a minute ago. Here we have a face value $2,000, discount rate is 6%, term of 90 days. We calculated our discount, and once we have our bank discount, we then can go ahead and find the proceeds. So let's see, where did that $1,970 come from? The formula for proceeds is maturity value minus bank discount. We have our maturity value, $2,000. We calculated the discount, and the difference between those two is the proceeds. This is what the individual borrowing this money would proceed out the door and have use of over the 90 days. They went in for $2,000, but because the interest was subtracted, they only have use of the $1,970 or the proceeds during the length of the loan. Here we have a sample where they're asking us to determine the proceeds. We're back to the example that we had two screens back. We calculated the discount of $12, and they're asking us for the proceeds. So proceeds are found by taking the maturity value or face value minus B, the bank discount or just discount. The maturity value is $800. The discount is 12. The proceeds or the amount of money this individual actually would have use of during the 120 days is the proceed amount, $788. We're now going to take a look at computing the discounted proceeds. In this example, we have a simple discount note with a face value of $14,250. The banker is going to discount the 8-month note at 8%. So here we're given the term and the percentage, and we are asked to calculate the discount and the proceeds. Discount is the casual shorthand for bank discount, B. B is found by taking the maturity value or face value times the discount rate, this is D, times the time, 8 months in terms of a year, so 8/12. When you simplify these values, you end up with a discount of 760. This is the interest that's being charged for the use of this money. And the proceeds, since this is a discount note, that interest charge, the bank discount, is subtracted from the face value. So we will take the maturity value minus the bank discount. So face value or maturity value, $14,250 minus the discount or bank discount, leaves us with a proceeds. This is the amount of money the individual uses during the term of the loan. We have another example, given a face value of $1,250, discount rate of 11%, and terms of 150 days, asking us the same two questions. What is the bank discount? This is the charge for the use of the money. We will take the face value or maturity value times the discount rate, D, times T, the time expressed in terms of a year, giving us a charge of $57.29. When we're working with money, we're always rounded to two decimal places or the nearest cent. Once we have the bank discount, we can calculate the proceeds by taking the maturity value minus the bank discount that we just found, resulting in the amount that the individual will have the use of during the 150-day loan.